In 2003, I was a resident in internal medicine at the University of Toronto. I worked through the SARS crisis, and I will always remember it as an incredibly difficult time. One of the things that I recall is that there was very little conversation about how difficult this was for us personally. And so as I reflect back on that experience, as a medical educator, I've been thinking about how critically important it is for us to create opportunities for dialogue with our learners about exactly what they are experiencing at this moment in time. I've also been thinking about how important it is for us to normalize their emotions. Fear, uncertainty, and apprehension are all things that we're encountering right now. But if we don't talk about it, we run the risk of our learners thinking that they are the only ones who are struggling with those kinds of difficult emotions. So open dialogue and also a window into how we ourselves are managing those difficult feelings and experiences, I think is critically important and offers our learners a chance to see how we are navigating the situation as well. And finally, I found myself thinking about after. What is it going to be like knowing that we are a profession that has been dealing with high levels of burnout and also mental health challenges in terms of stigma and openness in our culture? We're going through an incredibly difficult experience now. And in the aftermath, will we find that our rates of burnout and challenge are even higher? We have to be ready for that, and we have to begin to anticipate how we may find ourselves delivering services and creating ongoing dialogue around the aftermath of this experience. But I also think it's important to remember and emphasize that, like all difficult experiences in our lives, this crisis will have a beginning, a middle, and eventually an end.